Welcome back to another episode of King Kruk Gaming. Hit the like button, subscribe, and hit the bell notification so you don't miss out on any great content like this. Today we're covering day 7 highlights of CWL. Hash is starting us out with a Pekka Witch boulder attack. He opens up the core of the base with a quad quake. This attack is a low-key Noah's Ark. We asked Hash, what troops are you gonna use? He answered, yes. The E-Drag is funneling at 10 o'clock. The Pekka and the Yeti will clear out 12 o'clock for a nice funnel. He needs to be very cautious with his troops. Once they're in the core of the base, the only way he can assist them is by spell placement, the Warden ability, and prayers. He drops the jump spell and all of his troops are down. They're all going into the base. None of them are straying away. The Eagle will be one of the first defenses to go down. He pops his Warden ability early into the raid. He's not using a siege barrack, so it looks like he's gonna battle blimp his clan castle troops and take down the town hall. He's dropped the poison for the enemy CC. There goes the Coco Loon, and the battle blimp is underway. The obvious challenge he's facing is that the wide open space left after the quad quake has caused a small army split. He freezes the town hall so it doesn't damage his main army, and while they avoid the town hall's explosion, several of his troops will succumb to an early death thanks to the poison left by the town hall. The royal champion is taking down the defenses on the left side of the base. The king will stay behind, taking down the cannons that were protecting the town hall. He still has his queen's ability, and the scaly spell will help out with a single inferno tower. He freezes the scatter shot, and as the yak charges to the front line, he will tank for the rest of the army. And he just died. With only a witch and some wizards left from the army, it is up to the heroes to take down the remaining 25% of the base. The cannon has targeted his queen and forced her to pop her ability. It is now up to the scaly spells and the royal champion to take down the single inferno. The witch and the wizards are doing cleanup. He decides to pop the royal champion's ability so he can go straight to attacking the single inferno. And as the inferno tower goes down, this is a triple. Brought to you courtesy of Hash. E epistrophe tuos partiati stratioti pantiras. Coming in with a drag bat attack. Using a loon and a minion, he takes down two mortars. And we can see that Pantiras is trying to get his royals into the compartment and take down the Eagle artillery. And if he can pull it off, he'll take down valuable defenses such as the air defense and the air sweeper. Bada bing, bada boom. Pantiras has access to the compartment. Both of the ground expos have locked onto his king. It looks like his queen is not taking the bait and she's gonna walk the perimeter. But it won't matter, his king has enough firepower to take down the entire compartment. King pops his ability, takes down the Eagle artillery, he's working on one of the expos, takes down the wizard tower next, and unfortunately some of the barbarians triggered a tornado trap, and the king will go down, leaving behind the air sweeper. But the ice golem with a single punch takes it down right before it melts onto the ground. He dropped his royal champion to take care of the multi-inferno, essentially protecting the queen and the unicorn. The swarm of dragon and loons are down, followed by the warden. A single E-Drag at 8 o'clock is clearing out buildings on the outside of the base, keeping the dragons in the core. He's dropped the battle blimp and he has his warden ability. He's trying to hold on to it as long as he can. Meanwhile, at 3 o'clock, the queen's about to go down. She betrayed Pantiras and didn't give him much value. He held his warden ability, but unfortunately, it wasn't long enough to protect the Yetis inside the blimp. And he starts his bats over the scattershot. Hopefully, they avoid the town hall's poison. And they do. All they have to worry about is the wizard tower, but it's frozen. And we see a triple free swag for a triple star attack. Up next, we have Vandine the Bandito with the mass super wizard witch attack. It seems this base has been around a while, but it still trips people up. Vandine does not have this issue though. He's cracked this base already. He'll take it down with a little bit of elbow grease and a lot of muscle. He quad quakes open the base on two opposite sides of the base. And while this base initially looked like a maze, hopefully Vandine's army pays for the ace. Enough rhyming, let's focus on the attack. using 8 super goblins, Van Dien got rid of the 3 gold storages. He will struggle less once he drops his army. 4 golems come stumbling onto the base. The witches are right behind, followed by the super wizards. He drops his heroes next. And so the mayhem commence. He drops the siege barracks nice and early, and the town hall has been triggered. And with all the skeletons around, it's hard to know what the town hall is attacking. But it doesn't matter now, because they're moving on. Under the warden's ability, the throng of troops move on to both scatter shots in all 3 inferno towers. The king has popped his ability, and we have a swarm of barbarians joining in the fight. As they take down the inferno tower, they're moving on to the eagle artillery. The royal champion steps up to the 3rd and last inferno tower. Using her ability, it goes down. The queen is targeting the wizard tower to protect the witches on the outside of the base. Finally, someone's attacking the eagle artillery, and the royal champion will take it down. The only threat are the 3 wizard towers still remaining. But with the queen's ability, it shouldn't be a problem. And as clear as prune pie, this is a 3-star. Another one bites the dust by the bandito Van Dien. Finishing up this month's CWL highlights is Seminole with a Lalo attack. He breaks the wall next to the clan castle and uses 5 super goblins to take down the clan castle. However, a super minion and a headhunter were released. He drops the Coco Hound and Coco Loon right before dropping the blimp. He triggers 2 seeking air mines. He drops the Rage, the invisibility spell, and he lands his super wizards on the expo. But the first invisibility spell covers the town hall. He gets it right on the second one. The super wizards are now targeting the town hall. They take it down, and he still has 2 more spells. Let's see how much more value they can get. They're targeting the single, and they take it down. He saves 1 invisibility spell. Let's see where he uses it. Seminole is pondering from which angle should he drop his heroes to create a path for the Lalo. He drops his barbarian king at 2 o'clock, and with the help of a super goblin, a wizard, and a super wall breaker, the king has access to several key defenses and a royal champion. The queen comes to assist the king. Hopefully she also targets the super minion. The king takes down the royal champion, and he makes his way back to the air defense and the scatter shot. He dropped his royal champion at 3 o'clock and takes down the enemy grand warden, and with the help of a headhunter, the king also. The expo goes down, and as the heroes move on, they are encountering more skeleton traps. He'll have to pop his royal champion's ability soon. The queen staying behind and having the unicorn is at a good health level. He drops the invisibility spell protecting his queen and the royal champion as they step up to fight the inferno tower. After what seemed like a week, the Seminole starts as Lalo. Both hounds are down. The loons are coming right behind them. The enemy queen pops the first hound. The first haste is down, and the warden pops his ability, and he drops his minions to start cleanup on those heavy storages. The queen's still alive with her ability. He has enough spells to get these loons to all the defenses and take them down. He drops a freeze on the eagle, and the haze spell will get the clump of loons over the eagle, and they take it down. The Seminole has enough spells to swag, but he doesn't swag. He plays it safe and makes sure that he takes down all the defenses for a triple. Guys, right before the video ends, I would like to announce that Blue Valks is looking for Town Hall 14 players. We play in several competitive leagues. We have 3 clans and champions 1 for CWL. We are looking for talented players. I will leave the Discord link in the description below, and I will see you freeze in the next one.